Hi everyone, Sam Jackson here, currently still trading in Vietnam, Da Nang. So today I'm going to be picking up from my last session. And so in that session, we developed a couple of strategies using EA Studio focused on using the stochastics indicator. And now what we're going to do is we're going to use walk forward analysis to see if these strategies benefit from ongoing optimization. So I'll move to the computer and show you that's done. These are the two strategies we developed last time. And so I'm just gonna look at each one and we're gonna see how it goes running walk forward optimization. I'll explain what walk forward optimization is. So we'll just take the top one here and we will go to the walk forward. Now I'll just hit run and I'll explain and we'll maybe tweak the settings. So what walk forward optimization is, first of all, I don't use it in the reactor and I wouldn't recommend anyone does, just for the reason that it actually is a bit computationally intensive. So you can see just to run one analysis, it's gonna take a little while, not ages, but it, you know, if you've got loads and loads of strategy and doing a lot, it can certainly take its time. And so what it's actually doing is in the settings, we've got six segments set, 10% out of sample, and it's searching the best net balance. Okay, so what it's actually doing, it's split our 10 years of data into six segments. As we can see down the bottom, we've got blue, which is an in sample, and that's the data it uses to optimize on, and the green is then the out of sample. And what it's doing is it's picking that data, it's taking that data and it's optimizing with those settings, 20 steps, and it's trying to find the best net balance. And what it's then doing, if we took the strategy, we developed settings on it for this period without optimization, and then after that's elapsed, we then move forward and we select this blue period now here. Then we run it on this and we keep doing that, stepping forward and re-optimizing over this fixed kind of period. So you walk forward. And the benefit of that, we can see here, it hasn't really provided much benefit. In fact, the strategy is really worse. But the benefit of this is that really you can get more trades out of sample technically, because if we've just got a single, let's say 10-year sample size, and we take 70% of it and 30% of it's out of sample, then we get however many trades in that 30% of data. And that's our out of sample. That's our kind of unseen test data. Even though we've got smaller, we've just got 10% here, but because we've got six of them, we've actually got a bigger kind of, probably closer to 40% of the data. So even with just that 10%, we've got like a much bigger data range where we've got true out of sample kind of results. So that didn't work really well. I'll change some settings and we'll maybe use less segments. We'll maybe use 20%. Let's see how, and maybe profit factor. Okay, so what have I done there? Just change the settings a little bit to not have so much range for optimization. It's find it's optimizing on a different statistic, and we've used less segments in that sample. So we can see here that probably cumulatively half the data is actually out of sample. So we're able to get a lot more out of sample results. Now again, these settings haven't really worked well, but to see if the strategy benefits from walk forward optimization, what we want is we want to see that, well, this is our equity curve of the strategy that has no ongoing optimization. And what we actually want to see is we want to see an improvement. We want to see if we put in the work for regularly optimizing the strategy, that we actually should get a better kind of equity curve, that the equity curve should be better. In this case, it's worse. And we can see that here. You know, we've got our strategy, this says it's a fallback test with the last parameters. So the parameters are different for each segment. This green has traded slightly different parameters to this one, to this one, and to this one. They've all traded different parameters, optimized based on the results for these settings. And then this graph here, right at the end, takes the final settings and trades the whole back test. So this isn't looking too good. I think a bigger out of sample is better. To speed it up and also, you know, maybe more gently optimize it, let's use less date range. And maybe let's do the system quality number. Let's try that. Okay, so yeah, in this case, it probably shouldn't be so different because we've not changed it as much. It's a much gentler optimization. Ah, perfect. But in this case, we have got a improvement, right? Every single part is either very much the same or it's got higher profit and is better, right? So this one's been better and this one's pretty much been identical. So it's found those same settings. This one's been better. So generally, this is looking better. And you can see that using the last setting, so if we accept these, then it'll change to the last settings. And so So it's kind of suggested, well, actually, we've got a better looking kind of strategy now with the late sentence. And it's also suggesting that there is some benefit to walk forward optimization here, but probably not enough, certainly not enough for me to consider the extra effort it would be to then ongoingly kind of, in this case, every two and a half years kind of suggesting. So it's not really every two and a half years. I mean, I'll probably change most strategies by then anyway, but that's the concept of the walk forward optimization. If we go back to edit, it's going to have changed that strategy to have those latest settings. And so if we then try the same thing on the other strategy, and let's see, we'll use that, it keeps the same settings. If there's not a huge benefit, then you're not going to do it. And as again, it can take a while to do this. It's more of a tool for looking at each individual strategy or kind of tweaking ones that's worked well again, tweaking ones that you have that work well already, I would say. So in this case, we were slightly worse off, it seems, for the first segment, but then the other ones were all better. But again, it probably doesn't look hugely worth, but the overall strategy itself, again, is actually, you know, if we take those last parameters and then just test the whole thing backwards, we do seem to have an improved strategy. And so again, we can do that, and we've got the two strategies with difference. So that's kind of how to use the walk forward optimization tool. In this case, I could try other settings and other walk forwards kind of, I've just given obviously a couple of examples of the settings, and we found something that is sensible and actually to benefit, but not enough benefit to probably justify using it ongoingly. But at least we now know that if we did have a much improved equity curve using the walk forward segments, then we would be very tempted to go, well, this one will benefit a lot from being ongoingly optimized. I hope that was helpful. If you liked the video, please hit the like button. And if you don't want to miss future content, just hit the subscribe button, and I'll see you soon.